How many times have we come across this message before? Broken and corrupted scenes are nothing new to Godot. And while several improvements have been made, you might still see them quite often while reorganizing your files or after an unexpected engine crash. So let's talk about what they are, how to fix them, and some exciting new updates that aim to drastically improve how Godot deals with them. Corrupted files are a bit tricky, and the reason they are corrupted is not always very obvious. Let's see an example. Here I have a scene A and a scene B. Both of them have a script that exported packet scene variable. As you can see here. Let's go to scene A and put scene B in that script variable. And go to scene B and assign scene A there. You might already see where this is going. But look, we can save, close, and reopen them without any problems. No corruption or broken scenes. But then, the next day, after reopening the project, suddenly, the scenes won't open anymore. There are no missing files to fix, and the error message doesn't help us either. So what happened? Putting a scene inside an export variable will make Godot preload the scene, and as scene A preloads scene B, and B preloads A, we got ourselves a nice cyclic reference, making Godot unable to load it. This takes a lot of people by surprise, especially since it's only happened after restarting the engine. And we also can't fix this within Godot. There are no missing files we can fix, and we can't open the scene to remove that variable. So to fix this, we are going to need to understand how Godot saves scene files. Any scene object in Godot can be opened as a plain text file, and they are very simple to understand. In the first line, we have a scene declaration, with how many load steps it takes and a unique identifier for that file. Then it defines all external resources, other files that are used inside the scene, and sub-resources, the resource files that are created and saved inside the scene, such as collision shapes. And finally, we declare our nodes, a bracket with a node class, name, parent, and ID. And below that, we have any non-default value properties that were changed. To fix this example, we need to remove the scene B packet scene reference, so we search for its ID and delete both the resource declaration as well as the variable assignment. Save the file, and now we can open our scene back again. And this fixes the other scene too, as they are not depending on each other anymore. But the most common cause of broken scenes are still missing files. Every time you move files around, the scene's external resource references needs to be updated, and while Godot does a good job of keeping track of things, it can sometimes fail. Especially when you move files from outside of Godot. You can also break scenes if you delete files that are being used. The problem is that if your scene have any missing resource file, it will just refuse to load anything. So you can't even open it to remove the node that was used in that deleted file. To fix this, we do the same as before. Open the scene file as a plain text, and delete the removed script from the external resource declaration as well as the assignment to the nodes variable. Save it, and we get our scene back. There is still another more extreme way of scene corruption. This time, we don't get any missing file message or prompt to fix it. And the error message doesn't tell us anything either. The scene file should work, and it is definitely not empty. This is another example of cyclic reference problems. But in this case, we have a script file using preload variables inside them. The scene A still loads, but scene B is completely corrupted. To fix this, we need to remove the cyclic preload reference and reload the project. Removing the whole script from the scene would also work. And this is a more common case that you might realize. Let's say you have an enemy that can spawn copies of itself. So you naturally put a spawner script that preloads a copy of the enemy to spawn it. And after restarting the project, that enemy scene will no longer open. In some rare cases due to crashes, you might be able to fix corrupted scenes by making Godot regenerate its cached files. More specifically, inside the .godot editor folder. Delete your scene's edit states and folding files, or even the whole editor folder. It mainly holds info on what open tabs, folds, and selected nodes you had when you saved each file. Now a more common use case that I personally use a lot. I have here a scene from a previous project, and I want to copy this scene to a new project. But I don't want the game logic script, I only want the 3D scene to get started. So I copy the scene to the project, and try to open it. It won't open yet. I already had some of the models inside the project with the exact same path, so they are there. And if I press Fix Broken, Godot will search the whole project for files with the same names, and assign them. Looks like we got a couple more. This is great for when you have the same assets but in a different file structure. Now I can take the old models that were missing and drag them into the project and fix the reference again. I still need to open the same file and remove all game logic scripts that I didn't want. Also, my house uses an external material, and those don't update automatically. So I need to update those paths manually. But now it's done. I can import a scene from another project without too many problems. Finally, Godot 4.3 promises a lot of improvements to fix even more corrupted scene errors. But there is one very helpful one, that even got backported to Godot 4.2.2. And that is the ability to open scene files with missing resources. So in the last example, that I had scripts that I didn't want, now I don't have to edit the scene source anymore. I can just open the file, and it will work. Then I just save it, and it is done. This still won't work for missing 3D models, but it works for other types of resources, which is already a great help. And that's it. A good guide on how to manually fix corrupted scenes in Godot. I hope you learned something, and until next time.